Hi Pixels, this is Rina TV. Welcome to behind the scenes of my international TV debut on Jimmy Fallon. Wow, okay, so I'm still in a bit of shock that this happened and you guys made hashtag RINAFALLON trending on Twitter worldwide. I mean, I had to make a behind the scenes for you guys, obviously.
It is 11 night before the shoot. I'm doing this because I am not allowed to talk tomorrow. I've never thought about it like this, but apparently with your vocals, there's like a quota for the day. If you're having to do like 10 takes of singing and then you're talking in between, you're wasting your singing quota by talking. So I will be gesturing. I'm feeling kind of nervous because I haven't filmed a live performance in about 2.5 years. I'll see you tomorrow.
So yeah, I was on vocal rest on the day of the shoot, hence why you're getting a voiceover version of Rina. I did make a cute little sign because I'm lame and I have a resting bitch face, so I didn't want people to think I was being rude or anything.
Good morning everyone, I'm on vocal rest today, but I'm so excited to be here. I have resting bitch face. But don't let that fool you. Let's smash it!
Woo! Incredible.
So this is Aidan Tamiri, the director. It was our first time working together as director and artist, but I've actually worked with Aidan as a set designer before, which is what he used to do.
Is that kind of a vibe?
I just love him. He's so funny. Yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I was pretty nervous.
Crazy, call me. I just want a little bit more.
We'd only rehearsed with the dancers twice.
I want it all, don't have to choose.
Oh my god, my heels were so high.
Currently, I'm practicing my routine for Jimmy Fallon. Right now, I'm trying to master doing the routine in these pin heels. They look fucking snatched, but they are very.
I don't know what inches, I want to say maybe 6 to 7 inches.
Hi!
Hello!
Hello!
How are you feeling this morning? Good. On a scale of 1 to 10, how excited are you about this? 15. Wow. Off the scale. Oh yeah.
So this is Anna Takahashi.
How are you doing this morning, Anna?
Amazing. I'm glad to be back for our USA TV debut.
She is the incredible makeup artist who did the Sawayama album cover makeup, which you guys have all recreated.
Oh my god. It's my album.
Do you know this song?
Bitch, that got number one debut album, Metacritic.
Well, I can't talk.
I should stop talking.
She's always making me look absolutely snatched. I love her. She's so chaotic.
So shiny. Like plastic.
It's fantastic.
Amazing.
Oh, my tits look absolutely crazy.
We always have so much fun together. And that is Tomomi, my incredible hairstylist.
Honestly, that hair is epic.
It's so good. Got double extensions in.
Part of the fun of a shoot is chatting with them while I'm in the chair, so it's really, really hard.
Why is she whispering? Not remembered.
Celia is my stylist today.
I love it. Is that the final look?
Celia actually did the Bad Friend and Excess video.
Can I see?
I wanted it to look like a pirated version of Marie Antoinette.
I think it might be more stuffing.
Sure. Yeah.
Meets Fight Club and an underground money laundering scheme meets punk rock. Yes. but we had several fittings where we wanted to make sure that I could move in the outfits. We were gonna go for a more costume look, but I thought that it really wouldn't look very good on film, so we ended up going for more of a fashion feel and getting some incredible designers on board to send us some incredible pieces and jewellery.
How are you feeling?
I'm feeling okay. I have eaten, so I'm hungry.
How's the costume coming along?
It's okay. The breast, chest. Oh, it's not coming off as easily. It keeps snagging my wrist and my tit, and it's annoying. And also the poppers won't do up. So it's a bit stressful. But we'll get there.
Have a good lunch.
A little fun fact is that the green room we're using is actually the Pickle Factory, which is where I had my first ever London gig.
What? Yeah, and I remember being like, oh my god, I can never fill this. I can never fill 150 people. And now we're doing
Round Green Room. It was so intimate and it was sold out and I was so excited, and that was the first gig that my mum came to. She was shook that I actually had fans, and so was I, to be honest. Meet my band.
I'm Simone, I play drums for Rina.
Hi, I'm Vic Jameson. I'm playing guitar for Rina today.
And I cannot wait. This is our first gig.
Crazy, crazy excited. Haven't done anything on this scale really before, so.
Jimmy Fallon.
So excited, honestly.
It's gonna be sick.
I've obviously done big stuff, okay? I'm not like some small fry. No, I'm kidding. But this is definitely, this is mega for me, so. So excited.
It's our first gig! We auditioned Vic and Simone before lockdown.
Yeah, January or February.
Yeah. And then we're like, cool, can't wait to go on tour in April. And then didn't see each other until like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
Or something.
Yeah, so we've met twice.
This is our tour. This is our life now.
This is our tour. This is our life.
So this is actually the first time we're getting together to play something, which is so exciting. And I'm so shook that it's Fallon. What a flex.
What can we expect from the choreo today?
We can expect high energy, full out, and a lot of sweat. Yeah, I'm super excited. Rina looks amazing. She's been great. The girls have been amazing in rehearsals, so super excited to get started. They're very happy they're not wearing heels, although Rina's still like Bambi in hers.
Josh Pilmore was our choreographer for the performance. I love working with him.
He's gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
Okay.
These two are from STFU. Shirley and Shantae, Summer and Danielle are here, and they're from the Exercises. It's like two
hardcore. I don't know how the dancers, who were also so incredible, kept going. They were basically doing like cardio for 4 hours straight, which is so crazy. I like walk up the stairs and I'm dying. They were dancing in between takes as well, which is so crazy.
Okay, roll camera.
We did a couple of run-throughs and then a few live takes. It took a minute to get the lighting right.
That was just the first run-through. We just need to get the lighting just because it's one take, so we don't really get to do a lot, too much in editing. I kind of want more aggressive lighting. At the moment it's too safe. Also I look a bit cross-eyed, so I need to be careful.
So I really wanted this entire performance to feel as live as possible. I think that's what everyone's craving this year, where there's been no festivals, no shows going ahead. And I'd seen a lot of at-home performances, and to me, they didn't have that live element, that unpredictability, that movement, that excitement. I think a lot of them were coming out like music videos, which in itself is great,
but I didn't want to do that. This was the first time I'd ever performed any of the songs from Sawayama, so it was really, really important that that live element was kept intact.
I mean, gag.
Yeah. After this one, I'm going to need to go to the toilet.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
It was really important to me that we did this all in one take, which is quite challenging and stressful, especially, again, it's been so long since I performed.
I kind of got so nervous.
So there's a lot you have to think about. For example, if I'm walking towards the camera, sometimes the camera person doesn't step back in time. So I'm trying not to crash into the camera and also make sure that the light's still on my face.
You can go forward, but when you get to here, that's you out of the light.
Whilst doing the choreography, while singing and making sure the lyrics are heard, which is really important to me.
How's it going?
Great.
When I do live shows, I don't use auto-tune, so it was really important to me that it sounded kind of raw.
Little by
and I didn't mind if some of the bits were a bit off-tune or whatever, because that's what live performance is all about to me. I wanted to make sure that rawness was kept. So the main take from the visual side is one take. It just has those cutaways on some of the zoom lenses, the band and stuff like that.
I know you can't hear me, but I also nailed it every time.
No, you did.
My God, it looks like a munch too. No, it looks like an MMA. The nubbles.
Are you hungry by any chance?
I'm so fucking hungry. I'm so hungry.
And the audio is all from one take as well, which is also really cool, so I'm super, super happy.
Sick. It feels so live, which is really good.
It does. I think that's what's so good about it.
There was one thing that didn't go as planned, which was the outfit change.
It feels great. And then should we just try it now? Yeah.
I was meant to have the gown that I was wearing rip off me, but it just kept snagging on all the gorgeous shiny jewels that I was wearing.
We haven't dress rehearsed with this coat, so I don't know how to take it off, basically.
We just were trying to make it work.
Nearly. I mean, if someone can just pull it, then it will come off.
Yeah. It'll be like a Madonna moment.
Yeah, and everyone keeps
talking about it.
Me crazy.
It's like look at the draw.
Literally love of the
draw. But Josh told me in between the take that it looks like I'm thinking about the coat.
I feel like you weren't expressing enough in your face.
Yes, okay, I think I was nervous.
You were just panicking.
Yeah, okay.
So first one's out the way.
Let's just go for it. Yeah. It's after the coat didn't come off and then I panicked and my voice afterwards was just like...
It's alright, okay.
So I made a sad executive decision to take out the outfit change.
Yeah, I think I'm gonna lose the coat. Josh can tell I'm like... thinking about it.
But I think it was effective anyway, but you know, she loves drama. It was a bit sad that didn't happen. The girls' costumes were a bit tricky too.
Touch
went
your
up
face.
Into my eyes. And so my eyes were like watering and I couldn't really see. It's all good. We make it work. The joys of dancing in a mask.
And actually at one point Shantae took a fall. It was really scary because she fell on her hand. She actually fell and then she kept going. It's so professional and incredible, and I just would have probably sat there and cried. It was okay, she was all right. She just walked it off like a trooper.
The girls are incredible. The
mask is amazing.
We had this end scene where the camera panned down and one of the notes was a $100 bill with my face on it. Sadly, because of the length of the video, we couldn't have that.
I got my cash! Come on.
Are you rich?
Well, I got paid $300 from this, so that's good.
Overall, I'm so happy. You guys loved it, clearly, and I love that you loved it, and I'm so appreciative that you guys are sharing it and watching it and enjoying it, and I really hope that this was a great first performance of the record.
We're up!
So good. I'm so happy I can talk now as well. That's literally the best part of it. It's really sad when like you want to talk to everyone and you can't. I realize this is like the first gig for people, I guess, like technically since lockdown, and definitely Vic and Simone have been missing it. I've been missing it. So I really hope you guys feel a little bit of the live experience through this performance. I really want it to feel as live as possible. Oh my god, sorry. Just I keep noticing my hand! Alive as possible. I hope you enjoy the performance. Sorry.
She killed
Sawayama. Or should I get the attention on this
face? They literally, oh no! Like having a breakdown in the back. Like, Anna, get out of my shot!
Like Anna on fire in the background. I'm obsessed with the idea of you standing in my light, like the whole time. And then singing.
Are you gonna do backing vocals next time?
At the mall.
The pixels are coming for you, bitch. I hope you've enjoyed seeing the behind the scenes of Fallon. Thanks for coming along this journey with me. Sorry, I always get like this at the end of shoots.
Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. Hit that little bell notification. Yeah, comment any questions, anything, any slays, any yas, and we'll see you next time.
I love that I just did this whole thing with my pants.
Yeah, your pants. I'm sorry, I was still filming, but...